What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to set up a whitelist on your Minecraft server. Connecting to your Minecraft server to play with friends can provide everyone with a wonderful gameplay experience. But if you're only trying to play with friends and someone else randomly joins your server, it can put a damper on the gameplay. If you're worried about players griefing, or if you just want to make sure that only a select few are able to get into your game, the best thing to do would be to make a private server. This means creating a whitelist or allow list, depending on your edition of the game. In Java, no matter what type of server you're hosting, this whitelist feature is always available. All it requires you to use is a few commands to enable and add players to the list, so make sure you have operator privileges before you start. The whitelist feature will remain active even after restarting the server, meaning you'll have to manually disable it if you ever want it removed. Join your Minecraft Java server and then open the in-game chat, and then type whitelist on and press enter. And after that, run whitelist add and then the player name for yourself and anyone else. Now, due to Minecraft Bedrock Edition's design, there are a few more steps to enable the allow list feature. Head towards your Apex server panel and then click config files in the top left corner, and then press the Bedrock server settings option, revealing its contents. After that, set the whitelisting setting to enabled by clicking on the drop-down menu, and then you can scroll down and press save, and then confirm the changes by restarting the server. After that's done, return to the main panel and then head to the console area in the top left, and once you're there, you can run the allowlist add player command. Now, if you run a Minecraft Crossplay server, which allows the server to have Java and Bedrock players at the same time, the Bedrock player is going to have to join the world before the whitelist is set up. This allows the server to record their character's name so that the command will work. After they've connected, just run whitelist add and then the player name in the console area. It is important to keep the prefix period before their username, since the plugins for crossplay have this by default to distinguish between Bedrock and Java players. Here is a list of commands that you might need when using the whitelist options. Remember that if you're using the console, remove the forward slash before you execute. If you can't execute any whitelist commands for your Java server, then make sure you have operator permissions. You could also remove the forward slash and run them through the console. If you can't add players to the list, in most cases this is going to happen for crossplay servers. Remember that you have to include the period prefix for Bedrock players wanting to join any private Minecraft server. They also need to connect before you enable the whitelist feature. As for dedicated Bedrock servers, make sure you've enabled whitelisting in the server settings from the config files in the panel. Using the whitelist feature is a great way to make sure only the intended players are allowed into your server. This can prevent griefing, or it just makes it so you have control over who has access and who doesn't. This is the best way to have control over your server, and with how easy it is to do, it's the perfect step in protecting your game and your world. If this tutorial helped you today, make sure to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. And as always, we hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.